Welcome back for our fourth episode on the Algerian Revolution on my channel, Rebels and Revolutions. Today, we will focus on three key points: the Athos affair, French role in the Suez crisis, and the Battle of Algiers. On the 30th of October, 1956, the last British soldier left the Suez Canal zone and Nasser promptly nationalized the Suez Canal. Initially, French were not especially anxious to do anything radical with respect to Egypt since they were already knee-deep in Algeria. On the 16th of October, a little-known event had fundamentally altered French position towards military actions against Nasser. On that day, French Navy intercepted a suspicious Sudanese ship called Athos, which turned out to be carrying 70 tons of weapons and ammunition destined to the FLN. More importantly, it was very clear that this cargo was organized and paid for by Nasser. The Athos affair became the front page news in France and in Algeria, turning public opinion severely against Nasser as the main supporter of the rebellion. This event pushed France into the arms of Israel and onto a disastrous path which resulted in the Suez Crisis. On the 30th of October, 1956, Israel invaded Sinai, and on November 5th, France and Britain landed paratroopers in the area of the Suez Canal. Despite achieving their military objectives, under heavy pressure from both the USSR and the US, on November 7th, allies ended the shortest and perhaps the most misguided war in the 20th century. And here's the reason I'm bringing the Suez Crisis into this story. The aborted mission was embarrassing to French paratroopers, who were seeking victory and glory in combat in Egypt. It was enormously demoralizing to them, making them even more distrustful of soft and socialist politicians, both in Algeria and in France. They saw the withdrawal from Egypt as a betrayal, which in the eyes of the army constituted a surrender to Soviet and American pressure. This incident had solidified the break between military and civil authorities, which ultimately brought down the Fourth Republic and created a revolution within a revolution, bringing France to the brink of a civil war. Remember, in our second episode, I mentioned that one of the leaders of the FLN, Ben Bella, was captured on his way to Tunis. It's important to note that Ben Bella's plane interception, which was completely illegal according to all international laws, was not authorized by any civil authorities in France, and was, in a way, the first step taken by the army of their own volition. Even more curious is the fact that Ben Bella's plane was on the way to a peace summit in Tunis, where many hoped to find a way to end the Algerian crisis. Clearly, the kidnapping of Ben Bella destroyed any hopes of finding a solution. Leaders of many countries in North Africa, especially Tunisia and Morocco, were appalled by this action. This ultimately led to their direct involvement in the war, often allowing FLN troops to hide on their territory. The kidnapping of Ben Bella and the Suez debacle marked the turning point in the Algerian war, pushing French civil authorities out of the picture, while transferring power to the army, represented mostly by paratroopers and the Foreign Legion. Admittedly, the French army was much more effective in restoring the order and causing the FLN considerable harm. This success came at a massive cost of civilian casualties among the Muslim population and considerable escalation of brutality and use of torture by the military. Violence begets violence, and it's hardly surprising that the FLN had become even more brutal in its response. The decision was made to carry the war into Algiers in order to increase international and domestic attention to their struggle, thus starting one of the most well-known segments of this revolution, the Battle of Algiers, which lasted from January to March of 1957. In essence, the Battle of Algiers was a game of cat and mouse. FLN terrorists versus French military intelligence under personal supervision of General Jacques Massu. The FLN created a very tight network of bomb makers, masons, and informers. A 1,400-strong invisible army inside the city. The notable tactics were the placement of bombs in public places, frequented by Europeans, by young and attractive females who could blend into the pied-noir community, with Jamila Bouharid and Zora Drif being the most well-known names of these female terrorists. The FLN carried out shootings and bombings in the spring of 1957, resulting in civilian casualties and a crushing response from the authorities, who were able to kill or apprehend a vast majority of this secret network. Yet the brutal methods used by the French military created international as well as domestic opposition to French presence in Algeria, thus accomplishing what the FLN wanted to do in the first place. The Battle of Algiers was not the only noteworthy victory achieved by the army. I found the entire defense line separating Algerian territory from that of Tunis a truly amazing feat of military engineering, which effectively stopped the incursion of the FLN troops from Tunisia. While the Tunisian leader, Robert Bourguiba, was a committed Francophile, he did allow the FLN troops to be stationed on Tunisian territory, thus saving the FLN from nearly certain military defeat. This defense line was named after the prominent character in the cartoon Madagascar, Maurice. Well, clearly it was not. In fact, just like the Maginot Line, it was named after the French defense minister. One of the most important figures in this story arrived in Algeria, General Raoul Salan, who assumed the command of the French army. The French army effectively took control of the administration from civilian authorities during the Battle of Algiers. Salan and Massu had performed a military miracle, but at an enormous cost, both financial and moral. Yet, they felt that they are living on borrowed time, and that the politicians are looking for a way to negotiate out of the crisis, something that the army could not accept. In their minds, Algeria was and should always remain French. Algérie française. Next time, we will see how the FLN took the war to France, witness the return of de Gaulle, and talk about the effective revolt in the French army. Thanks for watching my channel, and I hope that you will comment, like, and subscribe. See you next time!